Steve Shives, who often makes great videos, often makes terrible ones. His recent video, Five Stupid Things About the Right to Bear Arms, is an example of the latter. Let's go through this. Number one, he says that in the U.S. it's vague and archaic. Steve goes into what the Second Amendment means, but never actually tells you what it says. Now, I'm not going to be that Weasley, and not only am I going to show you the text, I'm going to read it to you. A well-regulated militia, being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms, shall not be infringed. Now, he asks a few questions about it to try to point out how vague it is. Can we all have as many guns as we want, or are members of a well-regulated militia? Can government ban certain types of guns as long as it maintains the general rights to bear arms? Opinions vary. Opinions may vary, but the people who wrote this into the Constitution were very clear. We know because they wrote it down. They knew that government would become corrupt if the population wasn't armed. Why? Because that's what fucking happened. They just fought a war for 2 years against a tyrannical government and saw that the government's attempt to take away the people's right to bear arms had bad effects. If people could resist government oppression, it keeps the government in line, theoretically. The well-regulated militia part was clearly defined in many of the writings of the Founding Fathers. They left no ambiguity, and people try to make it seem as if they're saying, you know, it's only for militias that are well-regulated by the state. That said, the Supreme Court has pointed this out in D.C. versus Heller. I'm going to put the text in the description of the decision and what it said, what it says about a well-regulated militia, that being a prefatory clause announced a purpose to the operative clause, the right of the people to keep and bear arms, shall not be infringed. The court stated the amendment could be rephrased because a well-regulated militia is necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. Now, the idea that muskets were the only thing the framers had back in those days was just dumb. These are people who personally saw the advancements of firearm technologies. To think that they wouldn't be aware that further technology would exist is stupid to assume. And it implies that they're stupid. Now, Steve Shives falsely stated that the Second Amendment existed before semi-automatic and fully automatic guns were developed. This is false. Many of these guns did exist. This is the Belton flintlock that can fire 20 rounds in a pull of a trigger in about 5 seconds. This is the air rifle, which could fire about 20 rounds in less than 30 seconds. This is the pickle gun, an early Gatling gun. The pepper box revolver, a range of semi-automatic pistols were common and had options up to 20 rounds. So that's pretty ignorant. So on to round two. It paralyzes debate over gun policy. So does the First Amendment about banning books. That's the kind of the point of the Constitution. First, you need to amend the Constitution before you can pass laws that are unconstitutional. Well, theoretically. So, yeah. Number three, its loudest defenders are terrible people. So what? People say the same thing about the other side of the Second Amendment argument, that people who oppose it are terrible people, namely you for saying dumb things like there were no semi-automatic or fully automatic guns when the Second Amendment was written. Number four, countries handle it far more sensibly. And then he cites fucking Mexico. Fucking Mexico. You know, the country with more gun violence per capita than U.S. He then points out that Mexico has half the amount of gun violence the U.S. does. Yeah, but you have to control for population amounts. The U.S. has 2.65 more people than Mexico. Firearm-related deaths per 10,000 people a year, United States, 10.64, Mexico, 11.17. So, yes, they have a higher problem. So, yeah. So, Steve, if you're going to say that the Second Amendment supporters are terrible people and then immediately ask why can't we be more like Mexico is really kind of a lack of self-awareness. Now, as for Switzerland, they have compulsory military service, which pretty much every person has to go through. Through that course, they learn how to operate and use a firearm, and they can also keep their firearms. And getting a permit for those guns is actually a lot easier than he's making it out to be. And there's pictures of people walking around Switzerland with like fully automatic guns, so it's just nonsense. Number five, in some countries do fine without it. Then he cites the UK. Lack of gun protection laws or gun rights protection laws and the amount of less violence. While this is true, the UK has always had a lower gun violence rate. even before the gun bans took effect. On the opposite side of the coin, they have higher home invasions, higher rapes, and higher assaults. Now, why would I need a gun if I rob someone and I know that they won't even have a knife? Oh, yeah, that's right. You forgot to mention the fact that pretty much everything is banned there, including certain types of kitchen knives. And even the kitchen knives that you're allowed to have usually have age restrictions, you know, like cigarettes do. Now, I'm going to post a link in the description talking about to a video where he's talking about comparing crime stats of different countries and how you have to take everything into account. And you just can't be selective about the data like Steve Shives is. Like, for the record, we had sensible, quote unquote, gun laws in Chicago, and it was one of the most gun violent cities in the union. So you can pick your crime statute how you want, and I'm doing that for an example. Anyways, that's all he said. It was pretty dumb, and yeah, there you go.